Now we are going to see about the one act play called Trick. It is written by Erisa Kironde. I am going to introduce two characters, that is Kaligesi. He is a husband and he is a drunkard. He used to beat his wife. He is an old man and he has wife. His wife name is Kamuli and he is a young girl. And the play starts with the counting of rupees, which is earned by Kaligesi. Now Kaligesi is dead and he is lied in a bed and he is covered with a blanket. Now Kamuli is counting the money earned by her husband, and while this is happening, Kamuli hears somebody who is knocking their room's door. So Kamuli goes out to see who is, and there we can see a musician called Majan Goa. He asks Kamuli for shelter in his house. So Kamuli also accepts Majan Goa, and now Majan Goa, when he enters the house, he sees that a dead body is in his house, and Kamuli informs that Kasan Goa made a curse that I should not touch the dead body. So I should not touch the dead body, or no one should touch the dead body. It is a curse given by my husband in the morning. If he dies suddenly, no one should touch his dead body except his sister Sirisita. So his sister Sirisita's house is far away from my house. So it is night time and I could not inform this information to Kaligesi's sister. So I am waiting for the next day to come. So in this way, Kamuli says to Majan Goa, while Kamuli and Majan Goa talking, there comes a character called Kasan Goa. They are talking about Kasan Goa. He is a herdsman, and now while they are talking about Kasan Goa, Kamuli thinks that if Kamuli passes the information to Kasan Goa, Kasan Goa will inform to Sirisita. So Kamuli goes out of her house to inform Kasan Goa. In that time, Majan Goa sees the body of Kaligesi. Now Majan Goa and Kaligesi are in the same room, and while Majan Goa is seeing Kaligesi dead body, Kaligesi suddenly wake up from his dead body, wakes up from his dead body. While Majan Goa sees that, Majan Goa is shocked to see that Kaligesi has waked up from his bed. And Majan Goa asks, are you not dead? Then Kaligesi says that, I am not dead, I am thirsty, and I am acting like a dead man because my wife is a cunning fellow, and after my death, what will my wife do? In this way, I am going to say test my wife. In this way, Kaligesi says to Majan Goa, and Majan Goa use some varagi to make a test. Majan Goa use some varagi for Kaligesi's test. So now Kaligesi goes to her bed and informs Majan Goa to not inform to her wife. Now at the same time, Kamuli returns with Kasangu, and after returning, Kasangu asks Kamuli to marry him, because Kasangu has an intention that if Kasangu marries Kamuli, the money will goes to Kasangu. So he asks Kamuli to marry him, but Kamuli refuses to marry Kasangu. And Kamuli also identifies that someone has drunk varagi in a cup. Then he asks Majan Goa who has drunk varagi in that cup. So Majan Goa says that it may be some spirit of Kaligesi. And Kamuli also accepts the spiritual thought. And while this conversation is going on, everything is said by Kaligesi, and Kaligesi wakes up from his bed and scolds Kamuli that he is getting an affair with Kasan Goa. So he orders Kamuli to go out of his house. So But Majangua says that if Kamli goes out, she will be live happy with Kasangu. And so you should not allow your wife to go out. It is why Kasangu Majangua advises Kaligesi, and Kaligesi says that Kasangu has an intention only for the money, to so that he tries to marry my wife. So if now I am alive and the money will not be given to Kamli, I only have the money. So if Kasangu marries Kamli, there will be no use to Kasangu. So anyway, Kasangu will not marry Kamli. In this way, Kaligesi said to Majangua, and Kaligesi also insisted Majangua to go out of her home. And Majangua and Kamli goes out of Kaligesi's home. In the time, Majangua says to Kamli that, "You don't worry. If your husband leaves you out, I will take care of you. And there may be not money which I cannot provide like your husband, but I will provide happiness and joy in your life, which your husband could not give." In this way, Madanga asks to Kamali, and Kamali also accepts the musician's request. And in this way, both of them goes out of the home. It is raining, though it is raining, Kamali accepts to practice the life of musician Majangua. And after they went out, Kasangu and Kaligesi are joined together, and they started to drink varagi. And Kaligesi says that, "I will not scold you." Kaligesi says to Kasangu that, "I will not scold you. Only for scolding my wife, I scolded you in the situation. But you are a good man, and my wife only is a cunning woman. So now I will give varagi for you, and we shall drink while sitting in my house." In this way, Kasangu and Kaligesi started to drink varagi in Kaligesi's house. In this way, the one-act play ends, and we can say there are some themes in this one-act play. We can see the husband and wife relationship. Kamli is a good girl, and he is tortured by his husband Kaligesi. Now he is relieved from husband tortures and goes happily with Majangua. But Majangua thinks that Kamali is a cunning fellow, that Kamali cheats Kaligesi, and he tries to go out with other men. But it is not true. And we can see in another concept that we can compare Kaligesi and Kasangu as a colonizer. They are trying to control Kamali. Kasangu tries to cheat Kamali by getting married, by asking her for marriage. But Kamali rejects both of them and goes happily with the musician. It shows that native people will not accept the colonizer's culture, and they will only follow the culture of their own culture, and they will not follow colonizer's culture. And in this way, we can say these two themes are present in the one act play, the trick. Here, in this way, the play, the trick ends. Thank you.